As we headed north from BC's Gulf Islands towards Desolation Sound, something happened while at one particular harbor that we'll never forget, which makes this part of our journey particularly sad. Today we're on our way up to Wallace Island, and we're going to stop at Princess Cove, do a little stern tie, and then see if we can take the walk over to find the famous cabin.
Apparently there is some cabin where cruisers come and on a piece of driftwood or whatever type of art, they leave their name or message or whatever it may be. So we're going to go check that out.
She wore my hat. Without my hat, this is my hair today. So, time to put the hat back on. Okay, so we're coming up to Conover Cove, which is too shallow for us at most any tide, and right now we've got like a minus 0.1 tide, so it's way too shallow for us. So we're gonna bypass this and go up to Princess Cove where we can stern tide, and then do a little walk over here. That looks like a little cabin in there.
And here we have the first mate. How are you feeling today, Ingrid?
I'm feeling fantastic. The sun is out, and we are about to do something a little tricky.
Stern tying may be a bit trickier in a narrow anchorage, but the process we use is much the same as with any other location. We drop the hook about 5 boat lengths from shore, far enough out that we can have about a 3 or 4 to 1 scope to depth ratio. Then we back up slowly toward shore until the anchor grabs. Keeping the boat in a low reverse gear to keep us taut on the anchor, we bring a floating line to shore, which is sometimes easier said than done. Then, we pull enough line through the metal chain loop to reach back to the boat a second time, and pull ourselves back to the boat using the original line. Stern tying allows us to safely moor in tight anchorages without swinging, and this method lets us leave the anchorage easily by simply untying one end of our line, pulling through the shore loop back to the boat, without going to shore again.
Any thoughts on your stern tie, Princess?
Yeah, that happened just about the way it should happen, all except for I'm not supposed to get wet when I get off the dinghy.
The trail from Princess Cove to the cabin at Conover Cove is an easy 1 kilometer hike each way. We didn't know exactly where the cabin was, but it turns out the trail leads straight to it.
We know we're getting close. We found the old truck. Just traded in the boat for a truck. This is all I could get.
Oh, here, wait, I want a picture.
We found it. We found the cabin. There are so many boat signs in here. This is pretty crazy.
So we made it to the cabin on Wallace Island, and we placed our driftwood moniker on the cabin along with thousands of others of visitors that have been here before. And we were trying to find a couple that we've watched videos and have seen their journey here. And one of my favorites is Meraki.
Yes, we watched them.
But beyond that, we're still searching for a few others. So
let's see if we can find them.
Yep.
Treasure hunt.
Cool.
Princess Cove on Wallace Island was not the one particular harbor. That was still ahead of us.
We're all staging. We're getting ready to go through that little passage right here.
Max current through Dodd Narrows can reach 15 knots, so we have to wait for slack to make our passage through.
All right, he's going to go for it. Maybe you should.
He's going to pass.
Yeah.
Part of five sailboats all tight, close together, coming through at the same time. Yeah, right in the middle.
Don't want to hit that.
Oh, and we got some eddies in here too, pushing us around at the same time. Approaching Nanaimo, another place we haven't been to yet. I think our plan is just to go to the fuel dock and refuel and then call in and get our slope assignment. So we've got a lot of things to do here. Showers, laundry, provisioning, restaurants.
The last one of the summer, and so they're staying open later. All the shops and restaurants are open, and more entertainment, and I guess a bigger crowd tonight. So there we are.
Okay.
Want to
go through the bar and go
out
to the deck?
I am doing
it. As much as we enjoyed stopping in Nanaimo, it was not the one particular harbor. We still had another 75 nautical miles to get to Desolation Sound. And the harbor, which we'll always remember for the sad event that occurred while we were there, was dead ahead.
This morning we're on our way up to Hornby Island to Tribune Bay, and it's been a bit of a rough ride. We had up to 22 knots of wind, mostly on the nose, orcas off the stern.
And after we got a favorable wind shift,
we got the sails up.
There we go.
In Hawaii. We're in Tribune Bay, which is absolutely beautiful. I feel like we could be in California or, you know, somewhere south of BC. But it is just amazing, and it's warm and it's sunny and families are out. It's the beginning of a holiday weekend. And it just reminds me of summer, and it feels like summer because summer isn't over until mid-September.
We beached the dinghy and walked up the sand and put our sand anchor in. And in the short time that we've been here, the tide has come in this much that now our dinghy is floating out in the water and our sand anchor is right here. So it's a good thing we didn't wait too much longer. Bay that we just left, and this morning we discovered that Jimmy Buffett had passed away. So today is going to be a Margaritaville day, and we're going to celebrate the life of Jimmy Buffett with margaritas and Margaritaville music for the day.
But there's this one.
As we sail north to Campbell River and Desolation Sound, we leave Tribune Bay, our one particular harbor in which to remember Jimmy Buffett, possibly the most influential sailing music and trop rock artist ever. Follow us on Instagram at SailingSVIndigo and click to like and subscribe to catch all of our episodes sailing the Pacific Northwest.